In this lesson, we're going to go into DynamoDB and create a table. In the console, I've gone to DynamoDB, which is under Services and Database. In DynamoDB, we need to create a table. So let's go to Tables and Create Table. And we need to give it a name. I'll just simply call it My Table. And we need to give a partition key. So what are we storing in this table? Maybe we're storing some orders. And associated with those orders, we're going to have various information. Or maybe this table is going to be a series of users from a leaderboard for a gaming application. And we're going to store some information about those people. Let's go with that one. And we'll just use user ID for the partition key. Now, this can be a string, which is what we have here. It could be binary, or it could be a number. So we'll leave it as string. You can then have a sort key. And that allows you to be able to search for another key which is related to the partition key. We'll leave that blank, that is optional. Now we have some options here for default settings or customize. I'm going to click on customize so I can show you a bit more. Now we have something called capacity mode. So here we have on demand or provisioned. With provisioned, we specify these things called read capacity units and write capacity units. And what this is it's a way of actually defining the performance of your database. So you pay for read capacity units and write capacity units. Now, alternatively, you could go to on demand, and then you pay for the actual reads and writes that your application performs instead of provisioning them and just paying for 5 read capacity units and 5 write capacity units, regardless of whether you use them. Now I'll just leave it on the default here of provision. This is very low and it will be within free tier. We can create something called a secondary index beyond the scope of what we need to do here. And so what I want to do now is just create the table. I'm not going to change the encryption status. So let's just click on create table. And that's it. That literally took a couple of seconds to create my table. And we can see that it has a partition key of user ID. So let's just click on the table. Now, of course, there's nothing in our table. We do not have any items in our table at this point. At the bottom here, we could actually create an item. So let's just go ahead and do that. So maybe this is going to be the first user, and that's going to be me. So the value for user ID is nil001. And the type of that is going to be a string, and we can't change that. We could then add additional attributes. So maybe we need to add another string. And this one is going to be the first name. So that would just be Neil. We could have another one as a string, and this might be last name, Davis. And then perhaps we have a number, and that's going to be best score, and it's 900. So let's just create this item and see what happens. So now we have an item in our table, which has a few different attributes associated with it. Now, if we wanted to, we could go and just create more items, and each item can have the same or different attributes. And that's one of the benefits of a NoSQL database, because it gives you that flexibility. With a structured database like SQL, a relational database, you do actually have to make sure that you have some value in every single column. You can't have different columns for different rows or items in the database. So that's one of the advantages. Now, there's a few tabs up here as well. We have something called global tables, a really cool solution where you can create a replica of your table and you can create that in another region. So for example, I could then choose one of these other regions and have a replica created there for me. We can take backups. There's an automated backup, and then you can also create on-demand backups as well. So that's it for DynamoDB. For the exam, you don't need to know any more than we've covered. You really just need to understand that it's a NoSQL type of database and that you have push button scaling so you can scale it without any interruption to traffic. And of course, it's a serverless service, so you don't have to provision instances or manage them. So that's it for now. Let's just go and delete our table. And once I type delete and delete the table, that's it, it's gone. So, hope that was useful to you. I will see you in the next lesson.